Thank you, Sapna. Thank you, Mamata, for putting together a nice program. And let me thank Dr. R.C. Agrawal for his central role in supporting today's event and all the worthy vice chancellors. And thank you very much, Dr. Mohapatra, for being part of this important program today. Agriculture, we see three very defining trends that are obtaining. Number one, that we all know that from production to post-production challenges, and this is what these three legislations are all about, putting together a kind of ecosystem that unleashes the potential of farm sector. So post-production focus from production to post-production has to be shifted, and there the role of the universities. Second defining trend is that private sector is accounting for almost 94% of the jobs. 5 years back, we did for one long year the monitoring of the new vacancies coming up. So 94.5-95% was the private sector role in that. And third, of course, is the digital technology, that era we are moving into, whether these are IT-based solutions, or these are AI-based solutions, or we have data analytics that is powering the decision-making in the farm sector. So these three very distinctly defining trends that are emanating or obtaining in the farm sector. And accordingly, the role of the universities and educational institutions, from talent generation to technology generation to technology transfer, these three areas, as we put it, education, research, and extension. So I believe that in future, the course curriculums will have to be more aligned to the requirement of the industry if 95% jobs are coming up in the private sector. Second area that Government of India has placed a lot of focus, and we see that massive developments, like globally, we have about 6,000 agri startups. Number may have gone to 7,000 or more. Out of that, about 1,200, 1,300 are in India itself. So that is proportionately higher share of agri startups. Most of the agri startups that I think some speaker spoke about, are by non-agriculture graduates. So that's not an challenge, that's an opportunity, as Mamata had put it. So I believe that for long I have been holding personally this opinion that we need to create charm in agriculture, attraction, charm, and an element of glamour. So I think with this clear understanding, in 2008 when we started the Agriculture Leadership Summit and Agriculture Leadership Awards, the best of the people we put together, best of the location we chose, that Taj Palace, and best of the experts and best of the everything that we put together, we wanted that agriculture should not be seen as kind of barbaad ho gaya, loss ho gaya kind of thing, so dilapidated building and that kind of, you know, it. We must create a sense of glamour, because and that change has happened. Earlier when we used to travel, the person sitting next to me in a, let's say, in plane, if I introduce myself representing agriculture sector, it remained indifferent, it didn't mean much. But today if you introduce yourself, picking out your visiting card and showing, no matter what designation, somewhere if agriculture is written on your visiting card, that will prompt him to engage in deeper discussion till, in fact, the plane lands, he would not leave you. So everyone wants to now understand the opportunity for him. So that massive change has taken place. So this is defining that agriculture today in its best days. And that we have seen in the COVID period. I think Dr. Agrawal and many others have spoken about that. In fact, one group of ministers meeting I was part of, seven top most ministers, except the HM, everyone was there. So back to back two geo meetings on post-economic recovery, post-COVID economic recovery. The performance of agriculture, that time that figures had not officially come, that was, I think, July month, July and August, these 2 months. Everybody was so upbeat about the contribution of agriculture sector. So first time after a long time, we saw everyone so upbeat about agriculture, and of course, why not 24% growth in the agricultural exports. And in this current inning, the Prime Minister, in his very first public appearance, if you recall, I think on 9th June at Niti Aayog, the first public statement that came from Prime Minister was about doubling the agricultural exports. So opening up the trade, but effectively, we need four M's. As we say in management, we have, you know, in MBA, we were taught about 4 M's of marketing. So similarly here, 4 M. 1 M is about material, which means what we produce. And that is where the role of the technology. Then 2nd M is about money, that is investment. So we need to attract talent, we need to attract technology, we need to attract the investment. So 2nd part is the talent, that's again the role of the university. So second M is about material, money, manpower, and markets. So I think the last part of the market, that we are into a phase where we need to more effectively align the agriculture production system with the requirements of the market. That is how the more efficient a supply chain system, and of course the value addition part of this, so value chain development and supply chain development, these two put together, and the manpower that we are producing through the large network of agricultural institution. In fact, India, we have larger than probably US and China put together the infrastructure, agricultural research and education infrastructure that we have. It is larger than any country in the world. In fact, top two countries put together may not match what we have got. So little more market aligned and global market alignment, that will actually make our manpower absolutely, not only in terms of getting better employment, also powering the growth through new technology led startups that they'll be creating. And of course, back home, the supply chain and value chain, and given the kind of focus the government is giving in terms of funding the farm sector, I believe that much better days we can look forward to be part of that. Thank you very much, Mamta, and thank you, Sapna.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.